workshop of the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute. It's Thursday, November 5th, 2015. And once again, we're here with Mr. Keshe at the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute. Just a second while I mute that. And I think we're ready to begin the workshop. Mr. Keshe has a number of surprises for us today, I believe. So without further ado, let's move into it. Are you there, Mr. Keshe?
Good morning, good day to you, whenever, wherever you are, and listening to these teachings. As usual, Thursday is a public teaching, and in these teachings, we usually make some announcements, which is the pattern of our work, where we develop, what we are, and how we're doing. We don't have much announcements in a way, but there are some pieces of information which we have to pass on to you. As part of the Keshe Foundation, now being an international organization, we are responsible for every aspect of the Keshe Foundations around the world. Every one of you who work, use our systems, use our technology, develop our technology, you spend time listening to these teachings and others. We are responsible for you to guide you or in a way to inform you of what is happening, what it is. And Thursday morning has been a traditional way for us to do this for a couple of years. One of the main announcements which I have to make is the following. As you are aware, we are a space program organization. So being in that environment, we are developing new technologies, new concepts, new tools, new materials. And it's our job to try to set a standard. It's our job trying to set limitation and understanding of the new technology. In the Blueprint Week, which today is part of it, the second part of the second week, we explained in the first week how to use these Magrav systems, how to build them. We explained to you last Friday the dangers, the possibilities, the cautiousness you have to have in understanding the new technology and applying the new technology. The point goes another step. Part of development of this technology, which is the coating for the coated material, is what we call GANS. It's this material which you create from the separation of the molecular to atomic and then atomic plasma, or molecular plasma as CO2 or as a copper on its own. From the beginning, when we establish the production of nanomaterials this way, which was unknown, and we explain how we produce these nanomaterials on the copper plates or the way you do it with caustic. These are a very highly energy compact atomic structures. We always advise you to use gloves, don't touch them, don't breathe on them, or whatever. When we produced the separation of the atomic structure to atomic plasma, what we call GANS or gases in nanostate, or molecular structure of the same thing, we ask you not to touch, not to eat, be cautious with it, because it can have side effects, is a massive energy package. And a lot of you, you listened and you follow the procedure. I see most of you carrying gloves, touching these things, handling these things, which is a correct thing. In the Keshe Foundation Space Institute, we had one person who tried to break the rules, and he came up with the name Ormuz. There's something called Ormuz or whatever, and he tried to push this to create the separation and division of the Keshe Foundation from the beginning in the Institute. And one of the reasons I let him go was because of this arrogance. And I've seen nowadays this push that this is Ormuz, you can drink it, and people are drinking GANS or touching GANS, as this is Ormuz, there is nothing wrong. And we have seen somebody who's put it on the internet, taking a small amount of GANS, he stopped bleeding when he went to toilet. We see, and he said, I'm producing GANS in my urine. Red, containing blood. And then he was afraid of whatever. I've seen it, the pictures on the internet. So you have to understand, whoever talks about OMS, which is something which has been researched for a long time, has nothing to do with the GANs. Because if people have been drinking OMS and there's been no side effect, and if you drink GANs and you bleed, or you see different side effects, and you can create energy out of it, there are two different things. You have to understand, you deal with a new material called GANs, the way we produce it, separation of nanomaterial, separation of atomic structure, do not eat it. You can use this energy, but individually itself is so powerful that it can harm you. You do it on your own accord. The people who encourage you to drink it in the name of OMS, these are what are called literally people who are ignorant, have no knowledge, and they're trying to ride on the back of the Keshe Foundation. And when we inform them, it's just that we wanted to tell people. They're playing with your lives. The OMS, whatever they call it, is not GANs, because there's so much literature on it, nobody ever understood it. And people who touch GANs, you see the energy, you see the bleeding, and you see everything else with it. Do not touch. GANs is not OMS. GANs is what it is. It's an individual atomic structure of a plasma, and it can harm you. It can seriously harm you if you do not handle it the correct way. It can give you a lot of pleasure in energy, in medicine, and everything else. So my advice to you is be very careful and keep away from touching the GANs, eating it or whatever. And at the same time, be aware that it can be a lethal weapon in arsenal of the people who want to hurt, to bring danger to you and the foundation. This is very clear. Please do not touch, do not drink, do not consume, do not give it to your dog. Don't let the dog eat it, because we don't know what's going to happen. Because we've seen people who their dog have drank it and they say they're not eating or whatever. So it's an energy pack. It's one of our Keshe Foundation knowledge, because his dog had drank it. So, please understand, GANs is a GANs, stands on its own, it's an unknown material to the world of science in a way that we are used to use matter, and do not listen to the people who have no knowledge of the science and claim to be, because they used to be a student in the Keshe Foundation. The reason they're not here, because they never understood, otherwise they would have kept it. Keshe Foundation keeps people, scientists, people who work around us, who are intelligent enough to understand the technology. The ones who come here for a short time and then they claim they've been here, they have a right, don't keep, because they have not understood the process. There's no use keeping people who have no intelligence or understanding of the new technology. But they attach themselves, and we'll see a lot of these in the future. People who've been here, I've been to the institute, I've been a student. If you're somebody who understood, we keep. Mark was here, Armin is here. Other people who understand us, understand the totality and the learning, we keep. The ones who do not have the capability to do world transition and start different things, we let them go. But be aware, GANs is not GANs. GANs is not, what do you call it? Almost. There's a lot of paper on it. Probably people have done with it. Has never shown any proof of anything. With GANs, we show, we develop, you use the system, you understand the nanomaterial, the way it's produced by it, and you see the tools which is getting developed by it. So please do not touch nanomaterials, the way you produce through the nano layers using caustics, because you create a high energy matter state, and do not drink or use for others fun for you to put your life in danger. The second point comes to the position which the Keshe Foundation established in Belgium. We've received emails, we have passed the emails to the Interpol and the international police, who is looking after the case of the Keshe Foundation with the, what do you call it, with the European Court of Justice. We have, and we stand firm in our position. There are four or five people in Belgium who are putting Keshe Foundation and Keshe Foundation supporters in danger. We have received emails. We've seen how the access to the old files and the supports of Keshe Foundation in Holland and Belgium has been abused. And I do not see any reason for having such a huge support in Belgium, which has been our home, our base, for a few terrorists. Literally terrorists now that are in the hand of the police, the same situation which was in the pedophile case in the United States. These are cases which are running. We are getting informed on a regular basis what's happening with them. They're allowing them to carry on with their work. These people are free just because a lot of intelligence is gathered, how they're operating. They're happy that he went to the FBI and nothing happened. FBI is doing their work. We are fully aware of the background work. So the
hello.
So what I record.
Whoops.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you now.
Are we back? Hello.
Hello.
We are there. We can hear them.
Yeah. Hello.
Pardon? Yeah, they are testing for a few minutes today, they told them. They just cut us out. It's the final day. They say it should have no more problem, but I don't know why they chose Thursday to do it. But now we switched to the mobile unit. So we should have no problem. So what I was trying to say is that because of the huge support we have in Belgium, a huge number of the Keshe Foundation supporters are getting intimidated by the police officers, which we know who they are, and by the situation that sits in Antwerp. This is irrelevant to another thousands of Keshe Foundation supporters. So what we decided, we let the criminals to live their own lives. And we support the core team of the Keshe Foundation in Belgium. They are trying to intimidate. We'd go the other way. We work the way we do. We do the peaceful way. From today, I announce the following, and it stands for all the Belgian supporters. We have established, especially for you, Belgium at KesheFoundation.org. We open a factory in Belgium. We ask you, who you asked us to support you, we allow you to be the shareholders. Every single Belgian can become the shareholder. Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute, which is working operation, is a Keshe Foundation Research and Development registered operation company in Belgium. Keshe Foundation Power Tech Cell Technology, which is a registered active industrial organization in Belgium, from today announces we open the Keshe Foundation Manufacturing Belgium, and all the Belgians can become the shareholders. We finance, if you cannot raise the finance, to set up the factory to produce all the medical application, the power generator unit, and the, what do you call it, any other application. We don't get intimidated by a terrorist sitting in Antwerp or a terrorist sitting in Kortrijk. We respond internationally as a foundation. We've been told in the video message that the European Greenpeace group is prepared to take the Keshe Foundation case in the European Parliament against the Belgium rogue elements to bring the foundation in the European Parliament to make a decision what we're going to do. This is their job. What I'd ask you is, we have a solid base in Belgium. So in response to what we set up the manufacturing in Italy, the manufacturing in Germany and is getting set up, manufacturing in America and in China and in Japan is getting set up with the support of the Keshe Foundation here and in other nations like in Africa's, in the African nations. From today, we financially support the setting up of the Keshe Foundation manufacturing of all the equipments which we produce worldwide in Belgium. So if you're a Belgian and you were afraid of getting intimidated by the police officer in Kortrijk or by rogue people in Antwerp, putting your name as a fraud or as being frauded or victim, now the whole of the Keshe Foundation Belgium becomes a victim against five people. So we do not go back, we go forward. Get in touch with us on belgium@keshefoundation.org. We help you, we set you up with you, you can finance it, we finance you, we give you all the tools to start manufacturing everything in Belgium. We go in mass and let the other people do their job. They can intimidate 10, 20, 30 people, but they cannot intimidate a lot of Belgians who are the shareholders in the application of the technology. So please, we have a lot of friends in Belgium. You've been asking what the decision is going to be, sending us emails to me and to Caroline saying you cannot leave you alone. You supported us so long. So we respond to your call. We support you fully. We are a Belgian company. Now we set up the Keshe Foundation manufacturing in Belgium. The facilities are there. Dr. Michael, Michel, Yvonne Michel is there. And the others who want to set up these companies, we support you fully financially. But shareholding has to be as many Keshe Foundation supporters to carry shares. We set the shares at 100,000 units that a large number of Keshe Foundation supporters in Belgium can own shareholding. And the profits will go according to what you decide in your country. We don't make any difference between Belgium and other nations the way it is. We carry 51% shares, which the profit goes back to the Belgium society, and you carry the 49%. All of you, you supported Keshe Foundation. Now you can own shares in what you supported. You don't know manufacturing. There are others who know. We can give you the what do you call it, the presses, the patterns, the forms, the casting, everything which we supply to others is available to you from today. You can start running and setting up your factories. And if you're short financially, Keshe Foundation Italy, through Keshe Power Cell Belgium, we have enough cash reserve in Belgium, in the bank, to support you to start a company. You don't need even to look at, because Keshe Power Cell Belgium is self-sufficient with a huge amount of cash in cash reserve in the bank. So we are not going out to look. What we have gathered in Belgium, we support you to build up the company, to produce, bring employment to Belgium, and bring security in people understanding the application of the technology in Belgium in bigger masses. Instead of retrieving, we are going forward. It's for them to do what they do. We do not get involved in the legal criminal investigation which is going on in European Federal Police in respect to the activities of people in Belgium. This is in the hand of the Chief Prosecutor of Italy. He makes the decision in conjunction with the Chief European Head of Prosecutors, what they're going to handle with what's happening in Belgium. We separate the two from today, and it has nothing to do with each other. So, Belgium supporters, you thought we left you in a way we had to do to be able to survive. Now, we respond back to your support for 10 years for us. You can start building the factory. You can start setting the structure of the Keshe Foundation Belgium, and we support you. And this comes out of the finances which is sitting in Belgium. We are not looking outside. I can authorize immediately 20,000, 30,000 euro into the new company for shareholding and rental and operation. And I ask people like Dr. Yvonne Michel, Wim, who is sitting in the background as one of our knowledge seekers, and the rest, instead of retrieving, we're going forward, please, all the Keshe Foundations. And those Keshe Foundation supporters, like people who've been close to us, and it stood a lot of persecution from these police forces, we give you shares free in the new company because you paid with your life. with all the things that happened. We've seen people who've been close to us being under this pressure, and I think is enough is enough. So instead of sitting back, retrieving, we go forward the same way. My personal secretary in Belgium, he's been under enough pressure by these people. The other people who've been close to us, they've been intimidated, they've been to their house, they harassed them, they're taking their computers by the Secret Service, by one man, he calls himself the police officer in Kortrijk. And we give you full support. It's for you now to start operating the freedom. We are not a criminal organization, we are a scientific organization. It was to the benefit of people in Antwerp and people in Kortrijk to create such a position. The European community gives us a green line. Stand, we support you. Now we stand and you're supported. You don't need to go to Ford factory or to go to the Opel factory. Find a place somewhere where most of you in Belgium are well trained in producing nanomaterials. To others, you've been with me, you've been in the teachings, you most probably become the pioneers to teach around the world. So we support you in that way. You can support the foundation backwards. Now, we go back to our blueprint teaching. We have managed to complete, and as I said, if you were not in the teachings of yesterday, you should be start receiving your units, Magrav units, the energy units, the car units, today, tomorrow, in the next week, maximum by end of next Friday. If you don't receive your units by next Friday or so, or the following week, please get in touch back with us. We give you a tracking number. We do not release the tracking unless we hear that you haven't received your unit. This is for security reasons. And in turn, when you receive it, please go back on the teaching of the Magrav, which we've done, look at what you have to do and follow the procedure. Connect it the right way. Load it the right way. Understand what you can do with it and how to apply it. And let us know what you see, what we have to change, what we can add to improve the situation. There are a number of ways which are going to be done. First of all, when you receive your box, you have a two-page instruction on it. One of the first thing it tells you, go to the Magrav at KesheFoundation.org. Listen to the teaching, listen to the connection, how you have to connect. Understand the first thing you have to do is to establish your phase or live line and non-live line. It's very important that the first thing you get, or at least when you get your system, is to establish your phase and out of phase, which one is a positive and which one is negative. You want to tell them to quiet, or shall I go and shout? It's just women. Are they there or are they here? So, the next thing you need to do is, when you connect your system, connect it to a plug. Don't connect it directly to the main. Connect it to a plug at the furthest point in the house from the line of connection. What this means is that you do the following. If this is your system, this is your main, and as I said, this is the last house, this is the last room in your house, upstairs or furthest from the meter, plug your system at this point. And leave it with a very small load, maybe with the LED light, maybe with a small resistor of 400, 500 watts. and let it run for 3, 4, 5 days. What happened? The system you use the power, what you're using the power, start nano coating along the line around the house. So what it does, it prepares the wire work in a very soft way. So if you have a room here, or if you have a room here, as the energy goes through it, you start nano coating the lines. The lines get ready to be able to accept plasma. After a week or so, bring it closer to the meter, to your power supply, the main grid. After a couple of weeks, bring it closer. Here, try to use 500 watts. Here, as you come closer, go to 1 to 0.15 kilowatts. So you am I good enough? It's near my heart. This is where you want it all the time. It's the antenna, okay? So, yeah. So you start with 500 watts here, and then this is the first week. And by the third week, you go that way. Be careful if you have a washing machine. Try to work on your plug circuit if you want. Do not work on your light circuit unless everything in the house is non-resistive light bulbs, what we call the saving light. If you have any saving light, more or less, all your power consumption is zero. Means you take the energy from the plasma of the unit. You are not stealing electricity from nobody, because the same rogue elements in Belgium started the same thing in Antwerp. Not they are stealing power from the government. This shows the intent. None of the people you see who are on the internet who go against the foundation have ever built a single gas material yet. How can you guide somebody when you've done it none yourself and you've been with the foundation for 10 years? They have not produced a single nanomaterial element themselves. Ignorant hypocrisy. So what you've got to remember, when you put your system on, is how to produce, how to develop the system to be able to work. So do not use power, high power units at the beginning. Use low power, start the system nano-coating, and the system has a habit of nano-coating the system which you are using and nano-coating the wiring backwards. And then what you do, as I said, you are not stealing energy from anywhere. You are using the power of the plasma. You're releasing the energy of the plasma which you use. So in that bracket, directly, you start building the plasma power. If you remember, if you go back to the teaching in the Sansano, go back on the teaching how we built up to 129. We started with a very few Teslas, and then over the week, we came 10 Tesla, we went to 25 Tesla, and then we came to 129 Tesla. The longer you activate, the more GaN cells, the more energy you're releasing. This is where your energy comes from. It's the process of releasing power from nanomaterials. This is the way you release the power in the GaN materials. So the time you need, as you increase the power, you activate more plasmas to release more energy. And that's how it works. You don't tap into nobody's line, but in fact, what you do from the point when you connect yourself to the under the fuse box after 3 or 4 weeks, which has got to be done by an electrician, by a man who knows what he's doing, then you cover all your electrical needs, the power and the lighting. But remember, we keep on saying, and it's on your instruction, your maximum limit is 2 kilowatt total resistive on all of the appliances you have in the house. So does not mean you plug in a 2 kilowatt unit because it says 2 kilowatt maximum. You have to consider other units are creating resistance in the circuit too. So around 1.5 kilowatt is good per unit. We have seen in our test, and we're going to confirm it in the coming time, and some people have been told they have reported in their test, if you use one unit, once you, this has to be done in sequence. Once you've gone to the back, you add a second auxiliary point back to where you started, unit two, then there is a possibility that the totality cover can be increased to 5 to 7.5 kilowatts of energy consumption. But this has to be a continuous. Every time you switch on, switch off, you take to balance, and you, in that balancing, you see your meter reading, because now in that switching time, you use the energy from the grid. So be very careful in what you do. You can take a second unit, we call it the auxiliary unit. The auxiliary unit is exactly the same as the first unit. Why we call it this? We put a price for the donation. You already made your donation. The auxiliary unit is for the cost of what it is that you can increase your power. It's not that we're putting it to. You understood the way the Keshe Foundation works. The first unit, what you pay for the Keshe Foundation, for all the people around the world which can support to receive units and to create jobs in what we are exchanging for new technology. When you take the second unit, you can come and say, this is my purchase number of the first unit. Can I have an auxiliary unit? You pay what we put at a cost of around about 200, 250 euro, and then you get it. None of you at the moment need the auxiliary unit because you need another 2 or 3 weeks. Work with it, learn with it. You're happy with it, come and take the second auxiliary and push your power needs up. And again, when you do this, go through the same process with your first, second unit. Slowly load it up, ignite, and bring into power the plasma. And then you build it up, and what happens here at your point of the connection to your main grid fuse box, you start putting energy onto the grid, something like 4 to 6 times what you use. This is what I discussed on Monday in Rome with the Italian authorities, that we have no choice. You're taking the energy. We don't know how it's going to be, if it's going to be people using it, or it's going to become part of the national asset of the country. This is your decision, because you cannot stop. And the number of people in Italy and around the world who are start using it, government have to make a decision. That's not our position. But what happened when you put your second unit on, what happens is that now you're putting the 4 into your own home. That's how you create the energy. Here, because you try to cover the house, what you take in the house, you put 4 times more back into the grid. With the second unit, this is what you're doing. You're putting the thing back into the grid, but in the encapsulation of the house. So what you use, you cannot go more than 2, and this is the best way to do it, to cascade it. We've been told, some people say, well, if we keep it here and we go backwards and see what happens. Try it. Let us know. If you can push to 1.5, 2 kilowatt over the next 2 or 3 weeks on your furthest distance from the your grid, and you're feeding back into your house to nanocoat instead of going for the fuse box, after you've done the house, it'll go there anyway. But we don't see how we can support this unless we cascade it that the two phases of the power feed each other and they give you 5.7, 5.4. You can cascade the cascading on top and move it to up to 15 kilowatt. What does this mean? This is a process, a program which we have for the governments, for the countries, is that by placing, if we know there are a number of national authorities listening, is that by putting one unit in the center of a, let's say, a village, you start from the extremes with a few units, and then you build up with maybe a few more units within the city, and then you build up within a more intensive part of the city. You cascade, and we reckon through the same process, you can reach about 1 megawatt power. In a way, the power of your units cascading. Yes? Where did you lose him? We wait for him for live stream. Yes, we wait for the live stream. Can you call him on his mobile? Is he, can he connect, or does he need an auxiliary unit like we do here? Strange enough, there is no problem with him every except on Thursdays. Can he link back, or has he totally lost his internet? Is mobile not working? Pardon? Yeah, no problem. Would you like me to sit? No problem, we wait.
We are together, and I can no longer close my eyes. Feel the lies, who are those guys? Claim their rights to justify the war and hunger, who are those guys? Try the city on the run, lost their life under the sun. Claim the shame must go on and on. Let's get united as people come on. We're getting closer, stand in front of the doorway. We're even deeper, guided through the gateway. We have no choice, there's no other way. To step up, we have everything to say. We can pull ourselves out of the mud. In this suffering, set the dust. We are one way. We are together in what we are. We are one way. Shame must go on and on. Let's get united as people come on. We're together in what we are faced. We're planning, we are one way. We're together in what we are faced. We're together and what in our face. Thank you.
Hello, Vince. Can we have you found Rick? Oh, he's connected. Okay, waiting for you. Thank you. Hello. Hello, Wiz, are we ready to go? Hello. I'm like an impatient child. Why does it happen only on Thursdays? It used to happen only on Tuesday afternoon with medical, you remember? I wonder why. Thank you. Hello, Vince, are we going to go or are we going home today? What's the problem? What, the house is gone? And the raccoon had it? Only on Thursdays raccoon go hungry? Can somebody else start the live stream like Sandor? We need to set up a backup like this, second one.
Hi. Well, it's working so far, so good. I'll see what we, how we do with the live stream here.
Feed your raccoons, Rick. They don't need to eat your cable.
Okay, gonna start the live stream. Okay, we seem to be operating here so far, so good. Let me see on the sound levels here, and I have to. Can you give me a sound check again there? Okay, I have to get my Hang on just a second while I get the line in lined up. Tests go there. Okay, go ahead. Okay, good. Yay, we're ready to go here. Hi, everybody, back on live stream. I had some sort of major internet disruption there, and I'm back on my broadcasting from an iPhone instead. So we'll see how that goes. And so we're back on the 86 Knowledge Seekers Workshop, and let's get back to Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute. I see some things have developed on the board that we didn't see before. Not sure what we missed. Go ahead there.
You haven't missed much. Okay, Rick, we're back into the teaching, the second section. We apologize for the Canadian raccoons eating the cable up, most probably. Next time we try to feed them before the teaching. What we were discussing is part of the Blueprint Week, and that is the existence of what we call the when we go into grid structure, when we go into the national structure, when we go into the position now with so many units in one place. We've been suggested to do it for Vatican, but we'll see what comes out. What we do, we take a city or a village and we put reactors on a parameter furthest from the entry of the power supply grid substation. And then we build to the city center, and as we take, we go towards the station. Don't forget, I know exactly what I can do. Yes. We have a working Magrav unit for China. Ask them to contact Wins that they can go online. It's no problem. Wins, we just received a call from China. They have a working Magrav unit in China. Can Carl Amber send you the link? Look, check if it's correct, then we go back to it later on. So, he sends you the link. Oh, it doesn't matter. Okay. So, what it is, what I said is that we put the units in a farther point in a grid line and we see where we go in the cities. As I said, don't forget, I'm a nuclear physicist. My specialty is system control in reactor power supplies, power generators, in power stations, nuclear power stations. And I know exactly applying this technology, what will bring in the work. Part of our training has been grid distribution and understanding how you can bring grids into operation, understanding how it works. I've been trained for it years ago. If I remember still correctly, it'll be very easy to bring 1 megawatt power units in line. It will be done collectively by the people, not one huge power supply. What do? You keep on adding and backing up the same system as what we have put here in the house. One unit on its own gave you 2 kilowatt maximum, cascading 5.4, further cascading further out, you can increase the power and move in to the city. It'll take maybe 12 months to bring a whole city to 1 megawatt power supply on its own, to disconnect from the grid, to disconnect from the phasing. And literally, this is what we're going to do. This is a major work which we're going to carry out, start this project in Palestine and in Baghdad. In our work in the ambassadorial meeting, I give the surety to the ambassador. These two are very special cases. The grid exists, but cannot supply. People have generators on each street supplying themselves. What we're going to do when we have the units ready, hopefully next, by the end of November, first 1,000 units leave for Palestine, and we test it, is that we take a city with a generator and a small generators, and we take one generator and we add houses into it. This is, has got to be set up very correctly with the Palestinian ambassador and the Palestinian government. And then the same, we do the same with the Iraqi ambassador and the Iraqi government, but we move units and we take generators after generators. These are 2 kilowatt, 10 kilowatt generators people put, buy fuel, put in, and 2 or 3 houses take electricity from, because the national grid doesn't exist as such. But don't, I have a very good experience of how to operate this in our operation in Africa for years. I took generators into Africa to support our, what do you call it, the backup system. So we know exactly what we do. I've been involved in it heavily for years in working in Africa. So what we're going to do, like in Palestine, we take a section with generators, because the Israelis have blown up the power station accidentally. So we rectify their way, and what we do, we take 2-3 generators that they give us the 50 hertz, and we put units in one section. And then as the section is fully coated, we move the, we take the generators out, we go to the next generator station. And then we take the next generator out, we go to the next generator station. We take generator on the grid by generator out of line, and we give people with one generator the supply which is needed. And this is possible. Hopefully we can achieve it in Palestine and in Baghdad. And then we see what is the next step. So let's say by Christmas. Don't forget, the process in the cities are very easy, because they have all the facilities and the power demand is there. Don't forget, you build up to a power. The demand and the units for use are here. So it's very easy to escalate by units to backing each other. And then what we see, we can take the key one units and the intermediary units to be moved further back. So with like 20, 30,000 units, we can get the whole structure into position. Because once you nano coated, you don't need the intermediary units. You take the intermediary units, you go further back, backing the other intermediary. So we see 1 megawatt, a natural process for this technology. But it needs to be planned, it needs to be carried out step by step, and understanding the process. So if there is not an if, there's a possibility, and very soon, Alex starts the same process in Nigeria, and Benjamin starts the same process in Ghana. We've been told that the ambassadors of Liberia has asked for a meeting on the highest level in the Keshe Foundation Center next week. We extend the development to the Liberian government. They're coming here for a meeting, and we'll see what happens with what they call the Central African Republic, and another small African nation, that it will come together, that we do the same. Benjamin will move into Liberia very rapidly, because now he is literally officially embedded as part of the Keshe Foundation in the Space Institute of Ghana, in the nuclear industry of the Ghanaian government. He's embedded, he's now working as an official, except the document should be signed next 48 hours, but he's fully paid, and we support the Ghanaian Keshe Foundation Space Institute with the Ghanaian Space Institute together. And then we extend the technology development and teaching of Africa to Alex and Benjamin and other people who join us in Central Africa. So we are not talking, you will see, Benjamin will start teaching from Africa in the coming weeks as part of the teaching group, that you understand the position. And I was just explaining to Marco, we will take the teaching into classroom type. Like when Brennan teaches you, we ask that they start organizing 2, 3, 10 students in the classroom when he teaches. That is not just on his own. In each country, we are an international organization. So the teachings will be by teachers in their position in the living rooms. That's how we started. I was just explaining to Marco. All this teaching, the way you see today, it started with Willy, one man, asking me if I can explain the technology to 2 or 3 people. One Friday afternoon, it became the next Friday 5 or 6, and the next Friday there were not enough room in the people in the room. 22, 25 was the maximum, and then we went international teaching. Now it's the same process. We started here. We don't need teachers, students on the floor. All the teachers on the SSI, which is some 20 odd of them at the moment, I think. We have about 20 teachers or so internationally. When you start teaching, try to organize classrooms that people who like, students, other people, the Keshe Foundation supporters, they can come into the teaching. When you teach, like on a Monday or a Tuesday or a Thursday afternoon, they can come into your teaching rooms. We come to you nation by nation. Keshe Foundation is one nation. So classroom doesn't matter where they are. We work as one nation, one planet. So in the same process, now that we established the core team of the teachers and they'll be added to, now we ask the teachers to organize like a small classrooms, even if it means you have to rent a place for 2 hours a week, the foundation pays for it. It's part of the structure. We are financially solid enough to support Keshe Foundations around the world, because our financial solidity comes from you supporting us in different ways with different things you do for the foundation. So it's not that everything which comes to the foundation stays here. Now we announced the full support for Keshe Foundation Belgium to go into manufacturing. Most probably we do the same thing with German manufacturing, and we'll carry on with the others. So understand, if you're here to benefit by the technology and the units and the systems, support it to be accepted and to be running across the nations. I have no problem in taking the position back seat and letting you, as Keshe Foundation Worldwide, to take the destiny of the foundation in one word. Take the cash out of the foundation, but work as SSI, as I said before, as one nation, one planet, and start teaching that way. The structure is universal. Set up the teachings in a very orderly manner. I asked this morning from Marco to head the Keshe Foundation Institute teaching as the head of the institute. And if he accepts it, then you deal with Marco from now on in respect to the teachings. He's been here, he understands the way, as Armand is heading the Keshe Foundation manufacturing worldwide. So the process is very simple. I teach, I add to the knowledge, but now it's in your hand to bring the technology, teach the technology, and add to the bringing to commercialize what it is for the benefit of humanity. So the Keshe Foundation Space Institute on the teaching arm will come, that will add to the other side. Next week, we add into the research development of the Keshe Foundation, not next week, the week after, the water purification, dissemination, research and development here in Trani, in Valletta. The gentleman who's been behind our work with water purification and environmental cleaning, now that we have established a center, I have called him in. He supported us heavily for a long time in Desenzano, and now he comes here to head. So what it means, we start developing systems for purification, water purification, air purification, and all the research development immediately goes to the 5th floor in January. And once we make the prototype, it's working and it is what we think, it'll go to the factory in north of Italy to be manufactured, to commercialize, and we give the blueprint to every Keshe Foundation around the world to copy. this gentleman is well respected by me and Caroline. He's helped us a lot in this kind of things. He's given us the first, if you remember, the cheese water in the Sansano, where we did the test on it. And so as of literally first week of or next couple of weeks, if you have anything to do with the water contamination, systems for water decontamination, here in the head office, we have a person who's responsible. He's not a student. He's a full-time scientist. Well, he's been in this industry for 20, 30 years. Hopefully he knows what he's doing. And then we establish the commercial side, research and development, and the teaching. Whatever they learn, they come back to us. We teach here for public. So the organization of the foundation is taking its shape the way we expected it. But now the power units come in, the food units come in, the contamination units come in, agriculture units come in, and we'll see where we can go. Can you send us this link we can see today about the energy unit from China, Vince? Pardon? Yeah, on a Thursday. When would you go down? So how are we gonna run? Are we going home? You're finished? Okay. Please, while he's trying to link it up, can you go on the screen, please? While Vince is trying to link us up, if you joined us now and you're in Belgium, please go to belgium@keshefoundation.org, register your interest. You want to be a shareholder in the Keshe Foundation Manufacturing. We ask Dr. Ivan Michel and Wim and other supporters of Keshe Foundation to head this organization for the manufacturing, because they can stand the forces of the government. They can stand, they are powerful enough in their strength and resolute to bring the technology to Belgium for publishing public. Then you decide who you want to head the company for you and how you want to start the manufacturing. You have a couple of weeks, you can organize it yourself. We have a lot of ladies in Belgium who are the Keshe Foundation supporters. They've done a lot of work. Become the shareholders in the company which you want to be, which you work so hard for. We have a lot of youth who work for the Keshe Foundation. You can become the shareholders. Can you go ahead, Vince, please?
I do have a video as well from someone in Vancouver. Let me just get plugged in.
Can the Chinese working? Because if you go down, we can at least see what's happening.
I think you, I didn't do it properly, just a second.
Which one are we going to see, the Chinese or the one from Canada?
I figure I'd put the one in from Canada while we're waiting here. Set it up for the live stream so we can see. And okay, here we go. Oops.
This is my first Magrav energy test, so I'm putting a handrail and plug it into the system. As you can see, I can turn it on and it works. So I didn't add any capacitors now, but I'll be adding it soon and do some more tests and do energy consumption tests. Thank you. Bye.
That was a quick and sweet. The caller is it again.
You want to do it again?
Can we? Sidi was too quick.
Yeah, okay.
But it's nice the way he's made it transparent.
Just a second here.
Play it again, Sam. He won't play it. Come on, Rick, we're waiting.
Okay, here we go.
It's 37 seconds.
This is my first Magrav energy test, so I'm putting a handrail and plug it into the system. As you can see, I can turn it on and it works. So I didn't add any capacitors now, but I'll be adding it soon and do some more tests and do energy consumption tests. Thank you. Bye.
Do you want something, Rick? Hello? It is there. It's there sitting. We don't see it. It's the orange square. Wins. Yes, please. Do you know you're Canadian? This must be the biggest nightmare of your ex-prime minister. Seeing cash technology working in Canada this way.
Yes, fortunately he is ex, and the new prime minister has actually the name science in two of the new cabinet posts have the word science in it, and he promises to put a lot more funding into science.
Has it taken over yet?
Yes, today.
Today. Oh, okay. Congratulations to your government.
He has a new cabinet that's over half women and many Aboriginals in there as well. And it's geared up to be a much better cross-section of Canadians. So we're going full speed ahead, I think, with all this kind of technology I see.
As I say, welcome to humanity.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. We actually have a human as our leader now. That's nice.
Okay. Oh, can we have him online?
Okay. How are we doing there, Vince? What do we need? Do you have to cancel the
Can you send the Chinese video to Rick? If you go down, we can still see it. Okay. Or shall we look at the pictures and then go to the Canadian talk? Or do we have the Chinese guy on the line as well that we can speak to him? Okay, let's go and see. Let's go to Canada. At least we can speak to the gentleman. Rick, can you connect us?
Okay, I'm not sure. Was that under Ali, someone? Okay. Maybe he got. Yes, it could very well be. There's the people in Vancouver are having trouble with the network, with the cable network as well.
Okay, show us the Chinese pictures, please.
Yeah, Vince says there'll be another moment for the pictures to be downloaded. Ali, if you can hear me, you can try.
Yes, to get back. We can hear you.
I meant this person, Ali from Vancouver, that needs to reconnect with us here. He's trying to bring him in. He's not in the chat right now. Okay.
Can we see the pictures from China? Is Richard around? Has he managed to get himself into his lab for half an hour yesterday?
No, Mr. Keshe. Richard is on his way to an appointment, important appointment, and he'll be back. He's mobile. Yeah.
Kevin, we need to talk after the teachings today.
Yes, we do. Yes, it's important. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. What are we waiting for?
Well, trying to get.
Okay.
Oh, we got Vince is a blue just line.
Just a blue line.
Can somebody tell us what we are looking at?
Still waiting for Vince's picture, his screen share to come through. There we go.
Michael. These are the capacitors, huge capacitors. No, on the top. On the top disk, these are capacitors. I explained to you yesterday, I explained this to our colleagues in Philippines too. When you wrap these gas materials with anything, make sure they're fire resistant. It's very important that all the materials you use are fire resistant for safety reasons. Can we see the next picture? Can you open one window only? Who is this one? Pardon? Who are you? The output, is the meter reading. Yes. What are we looking? 2570.
The one power meter is for in and the other is for out.
Yeah, but can we see the in? Is 208. We don't know if these were zeroed or what is he trying to show us. Can we see what was the digit on the output? That's 208. Can we write on this somewhere? Well, we don't have no access to it. No. It's okay. 208 is the in, and what is going out? We need to see it back again, please. 257. But we're going to know if he started from a zero point with both. It's a 10 times, 15 times, or 12 times more. But which way is in? What is taken in is 2. He has put 10 times more out, 12 times more out. If that's the case, there's a huge escalation from what we've seen. We've seen maximum 8 times. This is 12 times. Can we get this guy on the line? Is there any other pictures to see? This is what is put out into the grid and it's taking 208. It's a very powerful unit. No, it comes from the GANS coating. Without the GANS coating, you have no power. Your power comes from your GANS and it looks like it's used the copper GANS. This is what you have with the power units from the Keshe Foundation Italy. The color, immediately if you look at the color, it gives you a very good indication. It looks like it's copper GANS or a composite GANS. The capacitors increase a step up. He's put 4 or 5, is it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, most probably, and 4. You need, he's done what we explained, and you see the power unit. Is there any way we can get this guy on the line? Vince? How did we receive the pictures?
This is Ali from Vancouver, and I'm here. I can show you the device if you want.
Who's speaking?
It's Ali from Vancouver. The video that you saw, the drill, I'm the person that made it.
Okay. Thanks, Mr. Ali. Can you just stay online? We're okay. Trying to start. Don't go anywhere. Just don't even mute yourself. Just keep quiet for a minute, please. Where can we get hold of the guy who's put this on the internet? Vince? Is Lisa online? Max was online this morning. Pardon? Was Aruba? Keshe Foundation Aruba has. Yeah, Keshe Foundation Aruba has just posted their system. Do you want to send that to Vince to go online?
Yes, from Switzerland.
Yeah.
Max from China.
Yeah.
Okay, it's the wrong Max.
Yes, thanks.
From China. I saw the picture, but I don't know who's the maker. Probably someone in our group, but he didn't contact with me. So probably later I can connect with him that maybe he want to show something. I think so. Okay, I'm asking now. Okay, just wait a minute.
Okay, let's speak to Canada. And we'll wait for Max from China to come in. As you know, Max, which you speak to on the Chinese community, he is one of the core members of the Keshe Foundation. He is a cornerstone of the foundation in running on the structure of the foundation. Highly respected by me. They are hardworking people in spreading the knowledge through the soul of the man, and we'll see their work. Okay, go ahead. Show us, Ali.
Hello, Mr. Keshe. It's great to meet you. So this is my unit, and as you can see, I put the three stacks, and everything is wired up. And for the central piece, I used ping pong ball, and just fill in the ping pong ball with the GANS material, the liquid, and then put a 15 amp. Let me bring it closer so you can see. Down a just put a, for safety reasons, I put a 15 amp here and, you know, run it through this. And this is the handrail that is plugged into the system. I still haven't added the capacitors, but if I turn this on,
let me explain. Okay, carry on, and then we, I'll explain something which is very important that you understand why technology is so important. That's beautiful. I like the way you made it in a transparent box, or is it in a box?
Yeah, it's in a plastic box, and you can cover it up.
Absolutely. Can you tell, can you lift it up that we can see it? Can we see through the camera that you're stacking?
Yeah, sure. Let me turn it off first.
Ah, so simple. Okay, I see your, how did you unplug and plug? You're gonna have a problem. That's because you opened it. The okay. Top, you just unplugged it, you just pulled it off.
No, it's wrapped around the...
Ah, okay. You put the camera
and I can open it up if you want. So I'll take the ball out here. We go to the next stack.
Okay. Are your cores on the same level, or are they ups and down? It looks one gravitational core to be higher than the magnetical, or is it just...
Yeah, it's centered a bit. It was centered by hand.
But are they on the same level, on the same plane? Or one is higher?
Yeah. So, and this is the next one, the next core on the bottom.
Okay. It's beautiful what you've done, but I'll give you a piece of advice.
Okay.
And it is here where you see your red tape, where your right. connection came from your magnetical, on the top, yeah. You yeah. cannot plug in and plug out. You have to turn your nanomaterial of the magnetical ring around okay. this wire. You cannot use any plug-in connections. You'll find out when it comes to power, you'll have a problem.
Okay.
Okay, so what you got to do, where you got your magnetical line out to connect to the output, you twist it around the wire. You okay. don't plug it in. Yeah, you get your magnetical from your magnetical coil.
Yeah,
so the output, yeah, and you twist it around the wire.
Yeah, that's what I did. I was twisting it around the wire. There was no direction in the plug. Yeah.
Ah, okay, no problem. That's beautiful. Thank you. Can you let us know when you add it up and we can see?
Yeah. I'm getting basically a tester to test the voltage tomorrow, and I'm gonna test how much basically I can save energy by using this device. I'll keep you posted on that.
I see you're Iranian. Ali Sharifzadeh.
Yes. Yes, I am.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for your work. It's a great honor to be here and to meet with you.
Thank you very much. Let us know what data you get. Show us some data. And then we go back. Thank you. Hopefully we see you next week when you've done some measurement.
Of course.
Thank you very much. Thank you for your time. Can we speak to Max? Have you managed to get anything from China?
Sorry, Mr. Keshe, I didn't find him. I think I could need to tell him to pass his picture to this email. May I speak that? Maybe probably he just submit his picture to this email. Want to tell him? Okay, I will try. Sorry.
Speak. Huh?
Okay, I will speak in Chinese. 大家好，是有谁在公布这个？就是说，咱们中国这边有哪位朋友在制作这个能量单元？这个图片，请那位朋友跟我联系一下。啊，请那位朋友来跟我联系一下，好吗？我在这个群里，好，谢谢。我在群里会发一条信息。
Hello, this is Lisa.
Hi, Lisa.
Hi, Mr. Keshe. I asked him before, I think, and he didn't reset to zero. That was the problem. I don't know. He didn't see what was the number before. So he didn't set to zero. That was the problem.
That's what we want to see. Hi, Carlos. Yeah, this is important to establish where they were or what were when he started. This is important. Let me explain to you. Good morning. You have another Romanian colleague. He arrived this morning from Romania. Yeah, we have people coming from all over the world to be here. Let me explain to you what is interesting about this point. By the way, next Thursday you might have a very noisy classroom because I think it's the Italian school has asked to bring bunch of girls into the teaching room on Thursday morning. So we have to go into our headphone translation system in the background. Either you organize it or Giovanni has. You have a bunch of teenagers coming to be students. Giovanni, what's next Thursday? School students are coming here? Okay, no problem. Okay, let me explain something very important. Very important. Why these systems are important. Why it's different. The Romanian greeting. What is important, if you notice, you bring the cable from the plug or from the grid. You connect through a wire, naked wire, and you put your GaNs coated coils in three stacks. And then you wind your end up and upside down, it's the same. This is your gravitational input, this is your magnetical output. And then what you do, you connect it to a copper wire, which you twist it around. That's why I said to Ali that you need to twist it around. And then this you connect to your appliances. In all positions here, you have used a nano-coated material to connect on. This is where the application of the technology comes into play. At nowhere from the point of entry, here, to the exit, there is any matter state connection. This is where we explain to you the energy comes from. From the point when you enter, doesn't matter you have capacitors or not in these positions, if you put capacitors here or you put capacitors here, from the two crosses. If I go here, what am I getting? I want stronger colors. Okay. From this point here to this point here, there is no matter state. The AC does not come in touch with the matter state because the wires of the whole material here are, if you look at it, are totally nano-coated. The whole structure sees no matter strength material. So here you put the matter state. From this point, you're only dealing with plasma. And this is the energy point which you see. So you put matter into a GANS plasma, and then you take it again from GANS plasma into the matter state. And here, that's the beauty of it, that the power at this end still gives you both DC and AC with no contact with the matter state. This is no connection between this and here. This is what you got to realize. This is where we say it's a new energy source. It's a microphone opening in the back. Oh, it's Fabio talking in the control room. So this is what you have to realize, that you have no matter state. Here you have the wire, and then you wind the nano coating wire on it. The same position here. This is why we say these systems are power supply, because it's taking energy from the GANS, from the nano air transmission. So you see, now you understand more how the system works. If you get your contacts and the flow of current correct, you should be able to increase the power release from this, as I said today, more and more, the more you use it. This is what is the new energy resource. This is what is the change from oil or gas or coal. This is another plasma release energy in the whole structure. So you see where now you can clearly understand. We saw it with you setting up all these things. You've been too busy winding up the coils and putting the capacitors and connecting. Maybe you missed this understanding. You have no matter interaction whatsoever at a point. You can in time connect to even the coils. You don't need to, because when you go DC plasma, you can pick up at anywhere. This is what we were teaching yesterday in an open teaching. So now, what I would like you to try, what I ask you to do, because it's a, as you've seen me tell you, and a lot of you are doing a lot of work in the background, what will be interesting is, don't go for three coils. Now you tested the three coils. We've seen the results coming in. People are working with it. Go for a single coil setting. Go for a single tray with magnetical double core, gravitational double core, a single capacitor on either end, and connect to a small battery that the AC of the battery, not the DC of the battery, allows the triggering and see how much energy we can get. These are the units which we are aiming for Africa. In Africa, we don't need kilowatts. You can produce a 10 watt energy bulb, what do you call it, 100 watt energy bulb, and a little bit of power will serve. We can produce these units very rapidly in Africa or in third world nations, that everybody have access to it using the battery itself. If you can get hold of a rechargeable battery, what we are testing now with our group in the background is creating a GANS battery. The GANS battery is the structure of the capacitor, but using what I taught you yesterday in respect to the surface of the earth, plasma outside, plasma inside, creating the heating or the current. How you make a plasma battery is very simple. You get a coil, you coil your system, you put a GANS of the same thing as you do, you put a GANS on a piece of paper, you wrap it around the coil. This is the GANS on it. And then what you can do, you can add an aluminium foil wrapping. You need a matter, the easiest one is the aluminium foil. You need a metal interface. And then you put a full coil, nano-coated coil around it. And then you turn your wires as usual. And then what do? You literally put this in a plastic container or whatever. You have yourself a plasma battery. This is no different, more or less, than the capacitor which you made. The only difference with your plasma batteries are these aluminium papers, aluminium sheets. You need a matter state conversion. So what you have, if I can go backwards, what you have is, I want to take more away. Okay, what you have is a nano-coated winding here, and you have a nano-coated plasma charge with aluminium foils creating your battery condition. These can give you 1.5 to 3 volts, can give you sometimes up to half amp. So then you can put them in series or in parallel, then you create yourself a small continuous battery for your, what do you call it, mobile phones or whatever. We are looking into this to make the new power generator away from the, what do you call, power unit. But with this, you cannot create a proper work. We are working on it in the background. We can indicate it and we teach you how you convert it as a new to a generator. So if you are producing, if you're looking for a small battery operation, which this thing will recharge itself, you might need to add a small capacitor at a point. That when the battery is charging, when it's low, the capacitor compensates for it, or you balance between the two. If you look into your, if you look into your mobile phones, there is a circuitry for this. There is a backup battery as part of your circuit. Capacitor, very small capacitor program is inside there. So what do you do? This is what I told you. We teach you everything. There is nothing hidden. I have everything I need in my life to live. My knowledge is free for humanity. So you understand what you're doing. You can do everything yourself and develop it and market it. A coil, if you look at this, you were making the capacitors this way. In your capacitors, you're putting a beam, and then you were rolling it with with a piece of paper with a gun on it. This is your paper. The red is your guns. And then what you do, you add an aluminium foil here, where in your capacitors, you didn't put the aluminium foil. In your capacitors, all you did, I'm gonna do it back again. In your capacitors, what you did, you only put now a coil on it. To make it a battery, you put aluminium foil, and then you add your coil, nano-coated coil. This is the difference between a capacitor and a battery. Battery itself is a capacitor. So you can start building long these capacitors. If you can, in a way, connect the positive or the negative, and understand a way of doing it, or make multiple of this. If we look at this like one on the top, looks like this. You can make what we did in the factory. Yesterday I looked at it, it's beautiful the way they made the capacitor set in the factory. So instead of you have a capacitor unit here, you can do the same with your batteries. Make four of them and connect two in parallel and two sets in series. You have both your power and your current and the voltage. So it won't take most probably less than this space if you make it. You have yourself a 3 to 6 volt to 9 volt batteries. And then add a stack of these to the stack of these. So you, anytime, if for example, the battery number one is working and is not producing enough, the battery two supports. If battery two doesn't support enough, the three or four comes. But at the same time, they continuously store. So in a way, you have 8 system backup in multiple. You build yourself a small capacitor, resistor, costs you, I don't know, 10 cents. So then maybe if you take it a further step, you add this unit and the power supply to your stacker unit. And then you have to find a way to increase it or find a way to bring in what now is commonly used or we call as inverters. If you remember, we spoke about the use of inverters in this technology with Mr. Bassan, who was the ILS volunteer. He is expert in inverters in Europe. He's one of the top engineers. So this is what we're talking about. But now you can do the inversion in a plasma to matter or plasma to plasma and start developing new devices. I told you, now that we start teaching plasma, we teach you everything. But you have to be able to understand it step by step. I told you by Christmas or before Christmas, we launched the battery, plasma batteries. Now you see it's already, it's just a matter of physically teaching, bringing a workforce to understand how to operate, how to make them understand the difference. This is what I said to Giovanni yesterday. We need to bring Italian people who understand the work of the GANs, they understand nanomaterial. We are advertising for people to work. We're increasing the workforce in Italy of the Keshe Foundation manufacturing between 200 to 3,000 in the next 2 months, 3 months. We are taking people who just want a job. But in the manufacturing now, we see we had to dump 75 units yesterday because it cost tens of thousands of euros for the foundation, because one of the workers never understood. He thought this is just what it is, and he assembled things the way he was used to. And I said, we got to bring people who understand the work of the plasma and teach the workforce. So you're putting training, teaching it to them. They look at everything as a matter. If they appreciate the knowledge, then they start caring and developing new units. Yesterday, we had a heavy loss in one system because one guy did not understand the difference between the matter and a gas use. So we need, if you're Italian and you work around the foundation, you made your nanomaterials, you understand how nanomaterial work, you're out of job, get in touch with Giovanni. We put you into the workforce, into the factory. We are looking to increase the workforce to 3,000 in January, February, and people who understand the technology have a priority in Italian. We are employing only Italians at the moment in Italy. This is taking me into the Italian nation, and we keep to our promise. So we need you. If you understand, you've been working, you're unemployed, you understand the nanotechnology, the way we do it, send a request to Keshe Foundation, Italia.Italy, IT, and Giovanni will start the process of what you call it. We will see if you are, how much you know, and then we recommend you to the managers of the factory to take you up as an employment. You have to move to north of Italy. If you live in north of Italy, then you have no problem. You're looking for a large number of employment. If you've been unemployed, you have the same, I think surely you'll be in Belgium now. We announced the backing in Belgium. In Belgium, we are much easier to bring the people in because we have a long standing of teaching in Belgium. The same goes with Holland. Richard is heading the manufacturing in Holland, and Kevin is part of the manufacturing in Germany. So people with the knowledge who've been around and done these things, now you can become part of the workforce in developing, because don't forget, after Christmas and into New Year, we are going for the spaceship development. So the workforce, once we go into the spaceship development, changes totally. We look, and now that's where we're going to operation with the space organization in Europe, and then the workforce of the Keshe Foundation of Space Technology will increase to 10 to 20,000 by mid next year. We are seeing it the way we are going. We're getting a lot of support because now people are trying. I told you, you are testing it. The government officials and scientists are testing much faster than you in the background. So they see what is to come. We pre-plan it and we announce it far ahead to be ready. So if you are and you've been around the Keshe Foundation development and work in Germany, get in touch with Kevin. Because we want to bring a workforce, which I understand, before we bring another workforce. If you're in Holland, get in touch with Richard. If you're in Belgium, go through the belgium@keshefoundation.org till we settle the management for the system and set up the company in the next couple of weeks. And then we'll see how it goes. If you're American, get in touch with Armand@keshefoundation.usa. We prefer to bring people with the knowledge in the US to join the manufacturing, which is setting up in Pennsylvania, I think. So once we start doing these things, it's not just the power units, it's the, what do you call it? The pen, the pads, the batteries, the amputation units, the water unit distribution, which is coming into operation. It's all these things coming together. We need a workforce, knowledgeable workforce, and you've been around, now is your opportunity to join the new technology. And in the process, you might come up with the new solutions, new ways of doing things, and we take it up very rapidly. Now, we need to understand how the system will work. In this situation, as I explained to you, as is a blueprint, you need to understand the work. You need to understand. By the way, before I forget, Rick Crammond in Canada is trying to sell the Keshe Foundation manufacturing in Canada. get in touch with him if you want to set up work. They're in the three stages, but as they build up, a lot of Canadians working this around, you can work together, bring it together. It's a huge support in Canada and set up the manufacturing, and we support you in every shape or form. As I said, the foundation has financial resources of its own. You don't need to look into the banks. For you to become rapidly commercialized, we are prepared to financially support you. Our standard situation stays, 51% goes to us, and what we get from the 51% profit is goes back to your nations to be used. It's just that we don't want to go into the same situation as we're in China. Suddenly the company disappears because somebody decided. This way, foundation is a 51% owner, stays in charge and in control of the commercialization. We just had a train. I tell you something very interesting about the train. I was explaining this to the Italian officials on Monday. Keshe Foundation has been asked, we've been approached at a very high level to participate in a rail operation in Central Africa. The budget has been approved for 11 billion development. And I said, why are you putting the African nations, which are under so much debt, for another 11 billion debt? If we can confirm and finish within mid next year, you don't need to cut the trees and everything else. You can take off and land, run the same train stations across without damaging the environment. So this is a challenge for me, and I'm working on that direction. And it's going to cost the African nations altogether maybe a million. They don't need to go under 11 billion debts. And this is one of the reasons I embedded, Alex and Benjamin in that section. Because the next step for us now is the development of the transportation in Africa in a very rapid way without building roads, because it costs a lot of money and they don't have it. But now, with being embedded in the national organizations, we can bring our knowledge and let the Africans develop it for themselves. I would like to thank, I don't know if Benjamin and Alex hear us, I'm sure they do, for all the work you are doing in Africa, and you have started bringing the change, and this is what we were here for. So start to see how a simple system will change. We'll bring the changes, and it's the job of the supporters to bring. I teach you everything which you need to know to this point. You have to understand the same principle. This way, I explain to you that what you see in this boundary, if you look, what can I take, which will be nice that you can see. If I go orange, you see, in this environment, you are in a different world. You are in a plasma world. You can do a lot of things in this environment before you go to the matter world. If you start understanding that your stacker units are not where they sit, but the fields embed across in all directions, now you see the field strength covers even the matter states. You are tapping in a way to the energy just on the shell of the material, trying to develop systems which can convert magnetical to gravitational to the strength you need using the stacker. You have an inverter in AC to DC. Start, those of you who understand, convert develop where, if you remember, the gravitational magnetical used to go like this in the teachings, you remember? Try to develop a system, understanding what you've done here, where you can get of a higher powerful gravitational to convert into magnetical, or take the higher lower of the magnetical into gravitational, then you can produce anything you like. We are looking for inverter systems, but in a plasma strength, not in a matter strength, not in an electron vibration into what do you call it, DC or AC. Understand the principle in the background, then you understand what we are looking for. If, for example, this was your gravitational and this is your magnetical, try to find a way that somewhere in between you can use one to the other to create new systems for conversion. And then if you can do that, it becomes this which we talked about. You can change at any step, at any energy level, magnetic gravitational field to be able to create new lines. You can choose anywhere. Now we have opened the power units into plasma. You understand how you create plasma. You don't need to work what you get out of there. These are the igniters, your matter state, and your, what do you call it? These are the matter states, what you put out and what you take in. Use these two to create new condition environmental creation of plasma. So you use the matter state to ignite the plasma. You use a matter state on the other end to, in a way, trigger the use of the plasma to feed itself. If you look at it, if I can take you to a step of further knowledge, you feed in your gravitational. You take out your magnetical. If you look, if I turn this slightly, new page, if I turn the whole thing, what happened to me? What have I touched? Where are we? There we are back. Marco is here. Okay, you're back. Okay, thank you very much. Oh, your meeting should start in a few seconds. I don't want a meeting. Get me out of meeting. I'm already in the meeting. So what we see is you had, if you look at it, your system coming out, and, well, it should be that way, your system going in, where you connected to your gravitational, and this was magnetical, and if you look at it, these are your three stackers, and these stackers created the plasma condition as we saw above. If you look at it and you understand the system, you have created yourself a plasma planetary system. If you look at it, gravitational field coming in, magnetical field going out. if you manage to create the second this thing again. How does this come in? Why do I get the bottom line? Hello, somebody help me here. How come I lost my bottom line? I've got an email. Oh, okay. It should be this way. I see what happens there. If you look at it, if you put either way an auxiliary unit, you see what happens. And you clearly understand now what the auxiliary units do. And the house, as we explained yesterday, sits here. You create a cascade. You create a plasma condition in the house. If you understand this, if you can extend the knowledge further, what we've been telling you for past few weeks, now you can see it, is this. You have the units, you have your units. This was your last room in the house, and this one was your unit at your power supply. And if you understood this much, maybe. Now you can understand. In a simple way, you have created an environment here where anything which is magnetic gravitational system will work without any wire, without any physical connection. This is what I explained to you, wireless power supply. Because if you are matter connected in your lines, you nanocode them. But if you understood what I explained to you just before, if I can go on a back page, yeah, if I can go here, no, go back. If you understood what was explained here, now you see how you can develop systems, you can develop technology in a very simple way using both your batteries and your capacitors in each of your electronic units to create a wireless energy supply in your home. Where if you see it, if you understand it, your capacitors in your batteries, energy source, will connect to the power supply. All you do with these batteries, or what I called yesterday the plug-in, you indicate where you want the energy to concentrate on. So this is the extension of the development in manufacturing. This is what we are working on. In a way, in the coming weeks, we'll give you the total Magrav power unit, which your supply, you can take all the wires of the house out. Wiring is not needed. It's like today's, if you moved into a house which was built 30 years ago, you have telephone cables everywhere. Some of the new houses built today, you don't see it because nobody uses a landline. Everybody is on a mobile. So this is the way we are going. And now you see how the, what we told you, wireless energy unit is going to be affected. And then if you go back on the teaching of the earlier on, if I can go another step back. Where is our thingy? The application, somewhere we lost it. I think it's somewhere we lost it. If you understand this position and you understood the work, now you understand how very simply in towns and cities you can have one central unit, total the rest of the city becomes part of the wireless network. This should not take us more than 12 months to achieve in some cities, because we're producing a few million units around the world with different manufacturers. Very soon this will be established automatically by itself, because they're all using copper as a conductor, so the bandwidth is the same, the strength wise of the magnetic gravitational field. All our systems are connected to the through the wiring system of copper. So very easily, all you need to do in your systems where you build, you nanocode a piece of wire in a circuit that it receives the energy. It's not that difficult. It just needs a bit of understanding and creating a copper gravitational magnetic field rings that your system does the same thing. A very simple thing, less than a, what you call, euro coin should be big enough. All you need is to create the connection. Then you can do it with a capacitor, resistors, or you can create a vibration unit to achieve it. So now you see how close suddenly we become into what we said. And the beauty of it is, every housewife can make her own electricity board. You don't need to be a genius. All you need is a piece of wire, a bit of material you use to clean up the toilet to open the hole, and a piece of wire and a screwdriver. All you need to do, find out. You don't need to go to a lead machine, hold it, and just keep on turning it backwards. This is fantastic, if you remember, for the old ladies who used to do the knitting, because they're used to turning it around their fingers and then going all they knew, now they go across their knitting stick. So you will understand very simply, the technology is at the reach of everyone with a little bit of extension and understanding. So one of the things we ask you, and if you could be open enough the same way to come back and show us, try to develop, first of all, these battery units very rapidly, because we are doing it, we're testing it, it's no problem. It creates a fair amount of energy. You have to see what you use, what kind of gas you use, how you nanocoat your material, and as you've seen in the beads with Alex, you went that way, and the same way you go this way is the extension of the capacitor. You got to understand, in the electronic language, a battery is a capacitor. Capacitor means somewhere where you store energy. A capacitor is where you store electrical current. A battery is where you store energy in a chemical condition. Yes. Try it. But the thing is, your heartbeat is only, what, 10 a minute, 18 a minute, or whatever, 60 a minute. Depends how excited you are. Try it. I'll give you the other end. Would you like to see? Anybody would like to try a drill? Would you like it? I think this is a live line. You can hold it there. Somebody will do it, I promise you, somebody will come up with it. The heart is too slow. The heart is too slow. It means you've never been in love. That's good. This is the right cycle. You try, tell me. People will come up. I can show you different ways to do it. In the way I'm spoon feeding you, you lot should be running by now. It should be a party with a lot of cakes on the different developments. I'm just there. This is a battery. Would you like some? I give you the what do you call it? The inspiration, but in a way, we are already testing this. And if you understand furthermore, in connection of these batteries in the plasma condition, you don't, or you can connect each of your plasma reactors for ignition to this system. Any questions?
Yes, Mr. Keshe. This is Kal-El. Yeah. I had a question about the, how you doing today, sir? I had a question about the batteries versus the capacitors.
Yes.
Most of the stuff that you were saying, Keshe, it kind of broke up a lot. So we didn't get pieces of it on when you were talking about the implementation as far as it being a signal for your stacker. And I just wanted to see if you could go over it because we didn't get it very much over here anyway.
Oh my God, you Americans have the most sophisticated backward system. We'll try to go over it again. A battery unit is where you put a coil with wrapped with a nanomaterial or a gas material in a paper or a tissue paper, and then you wrap it around with the aluminium foil, and then you wrap it with another nano-coated material. Let me explain to you something you can do very, very efficiently. Do what you did with your stackers. Cover this material, your coil here and coil here, with the same process with the GANs. Then you put the energy resources in it. Just don't use a simple nano-coated wire or a coil. Follow the same pattern. Nano-coat your coils and then GANs your coils. And then when you wrap it in the GANs, it's still the same, will work the same. Don't forget one point. You can increase the potential of your battery. This is different because we are in a GANs state. Here, I explained to you to connect four. You can do the same thing in a slightly different way. You made your coil. You put GANs on it. You put your another GANs, you put your tissue paper, or what we used before was tissue paper was green, then you don't get confused. And then you used aluminium foil. And then you used your another coil, and then you put a GANs on it. Now, if you do the same again, put more different GANs on it, wrap it with a cloth or a paper, as Renan says, that mummifies it. and then put another aluminium foil, and then you put another coil here. Now you see the power changes. Now you have a new power system. You can take power from this point, or you can take power from this point in respect to this point. You increase the power of your units by cascading cells inside each other. You can do it. All you need to do, you started with a bar like this. Most probably you end up with a bar, maybe this thing, to be able to cascade inside. If you start with a very fine wires, you can do it the size of a 9-volt battery or 1.5-volt battery. This is what I explained to you. Very soon, we launch new batteries that they never run out of energy. And this is how they're going to be. We start with very fine wires, we cascade it, it can fit into the standard battery. There is no need for new system. What we do, we cover the bottom half for this, and we allow a small capacitor unit here, and all you take is a standard 1.5 battery. This will never die. This battery lasts your lifetime, maybe for your great grandchildren. So now you see what you got to commercialize as rapidly as possible in a very simple way. You don't need to use gauge 14, you use 16, 22, you can go to a very fine and just add the numbers. So the technology development is very, very rapid. We have managed in one group to produce the resonance we are looking for. So it's how I think we go from minus plus 5 to minus 5 millivolts or 0.5 volts. We just need to amplify it into resonance, and then our power generator should be complete. As I said, we are on the verge of, once we complete it in the next couple of months, to complete the power generator. And then immediately we organize a blueprint week. We show you how. You copy it and then you develop it. So what you need, as I explained, this is the battery. You can connect the battery as a cell of four to a cell of four capacitors. As I explained, it will be done in the factory for the power units here. And you can connect it to your system, and you will find out you can connect this as a single cell or multiple cell to a single coil setting, not the tree stacker, anywhere for third world nations, which they don't use, they're not hungry for 10, 20 kilowatt with the air cores and the rest of it. You got to remember something in Africa or in third world nations. As you've seen, they're happy with a plastic bottle, where now they show, they put the plastic bottle on the ceiling and they can elevate the light of the moon, that it brings light in the house. You see how simple they live. So a system like this, most probably costs very few dollars, can change a lot of things. If you understand this process, very simply, your laptops can be connected directly forever, charged. You can open your laptop, build your own system, lock it in, and the energy is there whenever you call it. You don't need to recharge your batteries. You can do it yourself. We'll release this technology in the coming, it's just a matter of production and teaching labor force. Any other question? Go into production as fast as you can, anywhere around the world. You don't need multiple. Start with a little place in a garage, build it for your neighbors, and then add it on. As I said, we need 1 million manufacturers around the world to be able to bring this technology in line.
Mr. Keshe, this is Ali from Vancouver, and one of my questions is that do you recommend me to get in touch with Rick in regards to manufacturing? Is this something that I'm interested to get involved with and bring this knowledge to Canada? And I was wondering what is the best way to go about doing that?
Speak to Rick. Rick has already started the process.
Okay.
I've already sent you an email, Ali. So you have my email. I've already sent my email address and Skype connection and Facebook and so on to Ali.
In Canada, if you need financial support, Rick, to set up the manufacturing, we support you from here. And you know the conditions. You don't need to look for investors. The foundation will invest in Canada heavily because we know the workforce you need. It's just set up the factory, the position, and we will back you financially from here for the equipment purchase and whatever you need.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Keshe.
Thank you very much indeed. Any other question?
There was a question, how to connect the lines in the second class, two-layer battery.
Mm-hmm. Two-layer battery, the way you connect it is this way. You decide you want a constant what power. You take the center is your negative. This is the beauty of this. This I was explaining to one of my developers. This is your negative. This is your positive. This is your negative. This is your positive. But if you want to choose, this one becomes your negative. This one becomes your positive. This one becomes your positive. You've never had this freedom. Because now, this is in the center of these two. You decide what you're taking from gravitational, and you make it magnetical, and the same magnetical can become gravitational to the other. You understand? You don't need to look at this proposition. We have a unit in one research site like this. You have made a coil. You nano-coated it, you Gauss-coated it. And then what is done, the coil is mummified. And then is placed inside a gravitational magnetical coil set. So then you mummify this too, and you put a Gauss on it. And this is, as you've done before, you put your wire through the center core back out, nano-coated, Gauss in it. Now you have the same setup. Don't look at it as it's going to be one single battery. You can do the same thing here. All you need to do, put a layer of aluminium foil around your gravitational unit and insert it. All then you do is very simple. If I can get the color I'm looking for, then here you connect, you get 1 volt. Here you connect, you get 3 volts. Here you connect, you get 3. Where did I go? Hello. I am dead. I've gone to a different page. Okay, there we go. No. We go another page. Does it come up? Next page. Okay. This is very touchy. Previous page. I touched something which is gone. It's okay. Next page. Is not taking instructions. It looks like you, how did they erase it? Undo should help, but which page are we undoing? Oh, it's okay. It meant you're not supposed to understand yet. When things disappear like this, it means it's not time for it. Someone erased a lot of things. Master Fabio, what's happening here? Why have we lost the page? I touched the bottom, or did everything go white? I lost the page. That's my work. Where is it? Three. Everything's gone. Yeah, disappeared. This is the new page. No? So it means you're not supposed to learn. When things happen like this, it's not time for it. No, next page. We lost the data. We lost.
On the first page.
Ah! Oh, clever webmaster. it's okay. Yeah, but we're going back there again. It's a trick with this thing. Okay. Thank you, webmaster. Okay, we go backwards. Or we go forward. It's empty. Page 4. Yeah, but the problem is we are working on other bits which has disappeared. Okay. Doesn't matter. It means you're not supposed to know. When the time is there, you will know. Okay. Pardon? I thought this screen was supposed to store everything in the background. Okay, any other question? We don't know, we lost the last two pages somewhere.
Mass production of GANs will be very interesting.
Pardon? Ah, there you are. Thank you very much.
The mass production of GANs.
You want to mass produce GANs?
Yes.
How much do you want? How many kilograms?
As much as possible to just run a manufacturing.
Who's speaking and why you want to manufacture?
It's Rainer.
From?
From Valencia.
Valencia. Ah.
Spain.
It's a German accent, but in Valencia.
I'm living a few years in Spain now. Yes, but I'm German.
German accent, okay, no problem.
Yes.
We have somebody who speaks in Spanish if you want. Three of them, or two of them. Okay, we explain this, how you can increase your power and how you can add power. Ah, that's where it disappeared. This is what I was explaining to you, how you can choose different layers and remember, if you get your magnitude correct, you go like 3, 9, let's say 100, 200. You don't go that way. As you go, due to the change of gravitational magnetic field, if you get it right, you go up by order of magnitude very rapidly in gravitational magnetic field for your energy. To produce mass production, the way we do in the factory now, is very easy. You buy yourself a mixture of materials. Try preferably not to use aluminium. Aluminium creates a paste due to its construction when it's gas. Copper, preferably brass, because if you buy brass, you have a mixture of all the materials with you. You have zinc, you have copper, you have nickel, everything else with it. If you can buy zinc, what do you call it? Brass is better. Nickel, titanium, whatever you can get your hands on. You, the way we do it, we nanocoat one plate, we put another plate, put a negative on the copper where we want to go, and usually apply anything around about 2 volt, 1 amp. And you put in a good, what is done in a factory, 15% standard is good. And then you just leave it. One of the things you got to do is, please, as I explained to you before, get yourself a 5-year-old little fish tank pump, air pump, and continuously blow from underneath air into the system. Because then you increase the possibility of oxidization. It's much better. Try to do your connection as we done or nearest the plate which is producing. You'll find out your plate like this, what we see. Literally, you have it this much in the water and within a day or so, it totally disappears. You put the next plate in because all the atomic structure changes to GANs. As I said, we bought a ton of this for this purpose because we see the production. We need about a ton of copper per month just to convert into GAN system. It's a huge, because you produce all your nano coating and the GANs coating for the what do you call it, for your capacitors, for the center ball in the center. You need GANs for a huge amount of applications as you go along. So what we've done, we ordered a ton of plates in a specific way that we can just continuously produce huge amount of GANs, and we can do this. So we use nickel and something else as well. This is the fastest way to do. If you are going for producing medical units, then you need the copper and the zinc. Yes. Oh, steel iron is very difficult to produce. Steel is very difficult to produce GANs from. It uses a different current flow. For a soft materials like copper and zinc, 1-2 watts is very easy. This is how you produce. You can literally, what we do, you run a cascade of units. You've seen it with Renan last week, how he set up a CO2 factory for the plates or whatever. With a CO2 kit, you're at the mercy of God. How much carbon is there? You connect your air conditioning of your workers because they are the best CO2 supply. They breathe in and out into your CO2 gas stack. If you give a mask to your workers that whatever they breathe out, you collect, you can produce a lot of CO2s. Don't forget, you don't need a CO2, you need the carbon side of it. There is a possibility, maybe in the long run, we buy CO2 gas and just feed it in the environment where the units are. But that's a molecular CO2, is not so easy to create the condition you want. Next question, what's the time, please? Okay. Any other question? I remember Rick telling me it's 2 hours, 45 minutes, nearly 3 hours is enough. Now 4 or 5 hours is not enough. We started 9, it's 12 o'clock. We get no nagging to stop. Yes. Yes, you don't need it. You don't need to. You put a copper nano coated, you connect your brass to the negative.
What are the questions there, Mr. Keshe?
Wait, I'm coming. Okay. We are orange, excuse me. Your battery is run out. When it's not working is your problem. Oh, it's there, it's back here. Sorry. The Sandman is coming to you, no problem.
Two questions. If the quantity of metal that we use to produce GANs is relevant, how much copper nano-coated?
No.
Okay. And last time you said that the better form to produce GANs was a conus, but I was not able to find a conus to produce GANs.
What do you mean?
The form of the box.
Oh, the coins. That was for something else. Yeah, that's for something else. You're talking about... pardon? Coin. Coins. You mean this shape? Ah, that's for a different application. That's for the health application. Oh, you're so good, get it made for you. You go to a shop, you go to a metal manufacturer, says, can you hammer me a cup made of copper? And they say, yes, you pay them, they make it for you. Yes, but the copper is the best. It's got to be copper or metal that you can nanocode. Yes, you can do it, but copper is for what is there, it's for like cup of life. It's slightly different. Any other question? Or we stop for a lunch break? I don't get paid after 3 hours, unfortunately.
There is a couple of questions that there a couple of questions that are pressing in the live stream, Mr. Keshe. Jan asks, what maximum data rate, in other words, how much kilobits per second was already tested yesterday, mentioned at the instant Magrav communication system? How fast was it tested for, I guess is what he's saying.
There is no limit, there is no bandwidth on it.
Okay. And he has another question. Let me see here. He put that question in so many times that I can't find the other question now. So I guess I'll have to pass on that one. Let me see, there's some other questions here. If I put a ping pong ball of GANs in the triple stacker, don't I need to make a hole in the plates?
You put a ping pong ball in every level of a stacker, not just in one.
And it doesn't have to be a hole in the plate, it could sit on the plate, is that true?
Why do you need a hole? We made a hole for manufacturing that it stays in position. But you don't need to. Yes, Mr. Giovanni. It's all colors. Depends what the strength he has when he has it. Yeah, you get copper, even black. If you use like 4 volts and 2 amps, your copper becomes black color. It's more a nano state than a GANs state. Yeah, yes. You got to understand these Italians are pushing for their own teaching time. So what we're trying to sort out that you have an Italian lesson, or Italian teaching, as we have for the Chinese and the Spanish and the children. Now the Italians are muscling around here to get the teaching time 2 hours a week. We're trying to push them to the Thursday afternoon. Then we'll see what we can do. Anything else? Any other teaching? Any other question?
Well, we do have some other questions here, but perhaps we should take a break for you there now, or how are you doing?
No, it's okay. I will come back in the afternoon at 2 o'clock to answer any questions, and hopefully anybody who can show us any, what do you call it, any of their systems as they are coming online.
Okay. How about one quick one here with the instant communication question again. How does the instant communication system find the receiver? Will it be some telephone numbers or what?
Exactly the way your mobile phone finds you. I'll teach you in time. I actually taught you this morning, but you don't see it. Do you have a picture we can have a look at? Can I? From what was it? Did you send that picture to Wins to show? From where they showed their unit and somebody said there is something wrong with your meter. It's the same guy who said to us your meter in the Sansano is wrong. He has no knowledge and he accuses all the meters to be wrong. Anybody produces knowledge because he's against the foundation, he advised them there is something wrong with your meter. And now they produce energy on both meters, says something wrong with your meter. It's the same guy who says drink gas. Ignorance of knowledge goes beyond imagination. So we call it a day, and we come back at 2 o'clock if there is any questions, and we most probably have new people showing new things after lunch. Thank you very much for your time. And remember that we opened the door to the Keshe Foundations in Belgium, all your support of Keshe Foundation Belgium. We bring you back into the Keshe Foundation family with the more than open doors. Set up your factories, you can start producing. And one thing, your first thing you do, send a CO2 kit when you manufacture, a power unit you manufacture, and a medical unit, one to answer for the people who need it for the brain, one to the police station because they need it to enlighten themselves, and the CO2 kit, at least tell them to see what they don't understand, they need to understand. Thank you very much. Please contact Belgium at Keshe Foundation, and we are prepared to financially support the setup of the manufacturing in Belgium. And don't be afraid, you're part of the international family, not to be turned into a bunch of rogues and terrorists sitting in two cities of Fortrek and Antwerp. Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Keshe. Okay, that's the end of today's 86th Knowledge Seekers Workshop at the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute. And we'll have a public teaching this afternoon, Mr. Keshe, is that true, or?
Today it'll be public, yeah.
Okay, great, thank you.
Thank you very much.
So I believe we'll be back again on the KFSSI Blueprint Teaching Channel and live stream. And we'll also be on the Zoom on the regular Knowledge Seeker Zoom channel. Okay. And YouTube as well. Yes, can't forget that. Thanks, Vince. Okay, I'm going to shut the live stream down. Thank you, everybody, for attending.
We are one planet, we are one race. We are together and one pain of faith. We are one planet, we are one race. We are together and one pain of faith. I can no longer close my eyes. Feel the lies through our own skies. Claim their rights to justify the war and hunger. Who are those guys? Try the city on the run. Lost their life under the sun. Who claim the shame must go on and on. Let's get united as people come on. We're getting closer. Stand in front of the doorway. We are even deeper. Guided through the gateway. We have no choice, there's no other way. To step up, we have everything to say. We can pull ourselves out of the mud. In this suffering, set the dust. We are planet, we are one way. We are together, we are one way. We are planet, we are one way. We're together, they want to be a fake. We do it, we know it, and it works very well.